Amen, church. We are positioning ourselves for what? Revival. Revival is not just about Pastor Gundu coming and laying hands and then you fall down and you see seven stars and you wake up and you go. Revival is about you humbling yourself, fasting, seeking the face of God. And when you do that, something happens in the inside of you. Something changes in your life. And revival comes to town. I'm reminded of a certain queen called Esther. When things were so bad in her lifestyle, the Bible says all Israel was about to be wiped out by this king here because of a certain man. And the Bible says Esther said to her people, we are not going to eat for 3 days, 3 nights. We are fasting. We are humbling ourselves before God. And the Bible says when they did that, something changed. It stirred up something. And the Bible says the king, when he was sleeping one day, he could not sleep. He was troubled. And he woke up and he asked for some books to be opened. And he opened at the right place. And that ushers a change that serves the entire nation of the Jews. They did not go to talk to anybody. All they did was to fast and call upon the name of the Lord. Can I put it to us, friends, that when we fast and we pray, when we set ourselves, our lives, and commit our lives to the seeking the face of God through prayer and fasting, there are certain things that you want you to say with your mouth. Those things that you have been telling that husband of yours time and again, I'm telling every year, Daddy, let's save and buy a car like other couples. Let's save and buy a car like other couples. The dude goes and drinks that money away, even if he comes to Harvest House International. Prayer and fasting will achieve that for you. Oh, let me tell you something. Can I speak to couples? You can talk all you like until God comes. That dude is not going to change. You can talk all you like, but that lady is not going to change. But prayer and fasting can change things. If prayer and fasting change the heart of a king, surely it can change your husband. Your husband is foolish again. Prayer and fasting will change that foolish dude. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Am I talking to people with issues? Prayer and fasting will sort out your issues. Some of you are struggling with your bosses that are making your life difficult every day at work. You come here after church, you are joyful, you are revived. Monday morning, as you think you're going to work, your face goes sour. Prayer and fasting will do it for you. Prayer and fasting will do it for you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? 21 days of prayer and fasting, we have created this one specifically for your situation. When you humble yourself, when you call upon God, when you pray to the living God, God gives a guarantee. He doesn't say, maybe I will hear you, but he says, sure.